away at this tower, slow but steady.
It was a fair amount used, though, by Rocket, and you can see the core list to back away. The Soraka is benefiting Fnatic fairly heavily here, because what's happening is the Poe Clan Soraka heals it up, and Rocket, it's not an all-in fight yet.
Oh, that blow-through it did! And now the depth charge is coming. Yharnam takes a lot, so as flashing forward, the moment of poor positioning punishes Rocket.
I used to love it more. FaceTime with my shorty on tour. And she texting purple hearts cause she know that we at war, yeah. Niggas keep reaching and dissing. Getting four mistakes and I don't listen. Let me call my bros for assistance. You gonna make me...
Just go.
No. You can push bot in. Bot. No bot, my friend.
Done. Giving him a trigger seed. Flaxus looking to try and make a play out of the brushes. Chasing out of expect. Here we go.
Try and get that tanky Shen.
Well, he's going to turn back around after the fact. Keep on smacking him. Key burst.
It's going to be a long fight.
It will be a very long one. Especially still has flash, though. And taunt.
And Sven's fire.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, the arrow. That's not fair, man. He wanted the 1v1.
Sven doesn't even move in to try and be there.
Guess so.
Oh! Oh! Sorry.
I have 14 kills. Very interesting flash, good sir.
See, that minion deficit has actually shrunk from before, both in flat value and percentage-wise, so he can't quite stop the recall. And Erickson has enough control over mid lane. He's okay. Smithy, unlucky there. I think they would have liked to make the roam to bot.
How you doing? I see you got some shitty items going on. Yeah, Tabi, I like that. Oh, you got the control ward. Hey, the control ward. Got to put that down, man. I've been telling my chat for a while I can't put the control ward down myself. All right? So I don't know what you're thinking, but listen. Your control ward has got to go down, bud. All right? Well, you have a good day. See you later.
They could have simply pulled off and looked to force a fight around Infernal. I think that was just an awful call. And they were even just lucky that they got it. It was actually a missed smite, I'm pretty sure, from Acadian. I saw it go to 10 HP. So that could have gone over to their opponents. And if TL gets the Baron there, that would have been backbreak.
Yeah, I mean, right now, Akifox still holding a firm lead, 5,000 up. The two Infernals add gold that we can't see to TL's stats, which is nice. But as far as total current gold goes, Akifox do have a...
Hey guys, could one of you do me a favor and tell me what the cooldown on Alawi's E is? I think it's 12.
I'm just gonna look for bottom here. It's
okay.
Closest.
I think it's 12, but I'm not 100% sure. Could you guys tell me? I'm gonna start looking for the kill. What the?
Lined up right. There's not really a reason for Frog to be getting hooked there. Then the Maokai gets pulled into 5 plus a turret. Even he cannot tank that up. Keith does eventually get out with the summoners here. And as Golden Glue commits, Acadian lurking on the side, waiting for his opportunity. And here it is. As he comes up, boom. Everything lands. W before he jumps, so that lands as he comes in.
I mean, the scarier that Singed and Ryze is going to get, and I'm wondering if Camille's actually going to be able to do that much, because typically when you talk about Camille, you talk about a champion's inability to fight her. Well, Singed doesn't really fight you. He just sort of runs from you.
Oh!
Oh, look at that! The flip into the tower! There it is! Singed coming through with the big flip.
I'm surprised Sivir didn't press R. Or not Sivir, but the MF, because the Kha'Zix wasn't there to smite. So it might have been a free kill. You're so fucking bad. Do you think you can fucking fly out of a bush and one-shot me with your fifth drag? Hell no. Get the fuck out of here.
What?
Hey, I lived? What? How did I live? No! I killed him. How did I live?
Down him.
Very clean play from Cloud9. That level 1, or level 3, I believe, is hard to...
Right. Yeah, 3 minutes.
Be completely focused on that fight.
Slowing H2K, not enough though, because Jankos just leaps over everyone. Gets the tower, gets the kill, and H2K lose Oda Omne.
So we talked about the Jace getting further into the game against the Rumble, how strong it can be for Kaprashad. He's utilizing it. We'll get this bot lane tower as well. And he really is the saving grace. Nuke Dog!
He's dead already. Just gets chunked down.
He's gonna have to go out.
They're tanking with Daisy for a moment, but doesn't end up playing ball on that one. So as trading again with Faxi top lane.
But he's in tower range, and even though there's a big Gnar ultimate there, Faxi still gets the better of him, and he's actually chasing on Twisted Advance. He's got Flash, he might have to use it, he does. Faxi, he's trying to bait this one out! The 1v1! Soaz with the boomerang!
Boomerang catches it, Soaz.
They can always run first, Odo getting caught.
He is indeed, Chain of Corruption locks him down, but Vitality, they're out of support. Defensive flash from Steel back, and the exhaust slows down Febivit. Joko's running in, he's ghosting and Ragnarokking. Hachani and Joko looking for more. Kabo's got the double, the triple, that's the quadra. Looking for a pentakill.
Get it.
Continues to chase. Odo Wombra
shoots
out the Electro Harpoons, and Kabo cannot get the penta.
Almost, but
they picked him doing wolves, they warded him doing blue, and it's an easy red steal.
Also, Dardock could definitely wait around and get a huge chunk out of Moon's health. Level 3 Evelynn is a good target, but
misses the flash. Gets the Q out of the wall anyway! Bobo maybe not the best flash of Dardock! Minions in first blood! That is a catastrophe that should have been first blood! And now Bobo just missing his flash, exhaust is on. Damage out, but here, gets him into the wall, though they gotta be a bit careful. But here comes Shen, and that's gonna be the kill picked up anyway. 2-0 FlyQuest, and that's gotta feel terrible for Immortals.
Oh, shoot.
There you go. PG-13.
Hook not gonna land, a little out of range, but I like the angle from Biofrost. Vanskaren still wants in, he looks for Arrow, trying to take him down. Isolation damage is enough. What's a double get? Dive the turret, see you later.
Oh, 5 kills for Svenskeren. He's popping off. I said at the start. He got out of the air!
Firefrost, you god! Saves his jungler, prevents the shutdown, and makes it look good.
Well, that's where Svenskeren has to call him Bio Daddy for a day, because that was a sick save to keep that KDA. It was 5.
Be very, very careful with how you push. Look
Super
at that.
Minion wave is actually enormous. They have to send Faker to deal with that because he has the ultimate.
Here we go, we got the Baron started. And now is definitely the time for Pina to pull out all the stops and go for the Miracle Smite. Can he get it? He's gonna run in and, he gets him! He gets them both somehow! And now Bang is getting ultimated here. So maybe they can turn. Here comes Faker though, trying to come on in. And once he comes, it's gonna be so much damage added to the fight. But look at the burst damage out of Ian. It's not gonna be enough though. So many members of MVP super low. Pino jumping out of that burst over and over and over again. And that is the turnaround they were looking for. A triple kill for Faker.